Live on 2K Sports. This is Kevin Harlan along with Clark Kellogg and Greg Anthony. And of course, David Aldridge is joining us tonight from the sideline. DA, it's all yours.
Thanks very much. Now, with that ACL injury, Jamal Murray has had a lot to overcome. But his work ethic has always been a constant. He said, "I was very disciplined growing up. If I didn't want to run hills, I ran hills. I did it with love and I did it with passion. It wasn't work for me." Kevin, it's that mentality that still serves him well.
Absolutely, David. Thanks. When the middle of the season rolls around, Clark, how much value do you think there is in keeping an eye on the standings, seeing what the other teams are doing?
You know, Kevin, I think it's a balancing act depending on your team and the makeup of your squad, where you are in the standings. In some cases, it could be a powerful motivator, but I don't think it should be something that discourages you. You have to keep an eye on what's real and what you can control. There's still time for some dramatic shakeups as the season unfolds.
And checking out Utah's opening lineup, they've got Colin Sexton, Jared Vanderbilt out there with Kelly Olynyk. Then there's Jordan Clarkson, and it's Markkanen in at the three. And for Denver, Gordon steps in at the four with Jokic in at center. Murray and Caldwell Pope, the guards. And it's Porter in at the three slot.
He's got a well-rounded game. Murray can score from just about anywhere. And the more points he gets inside, the more space he gets outside.
And Olynyk kicks to Sexton. Dishes to Clarkson. To the middle. Here's Olynyk. Terrific assist. A nice finish. Solid play all around.
And getting the offense started with a high-quality look down low.
Now here's Murray. He's been putting up the points on a very steady basis, averaging around 17.5 points a game. And that's a foul called on Lauri Markkanen. That is his first foul of the game. Jokic with a screen on Sexton. Here's Murray, six to shoot. Rebounded by the Jazz. They come in fresh off a win against the Warriors.
They shot the lights out from deep. Really stretched out the defense in that one.
There's all kind of talk in the game today about stretching the floor, because when you do that, everything else just becomes a little easier.
And once he got to the 10, I think he was surprised to find himself that wide open.
Well, this early, they should be showing a lot more energy on defense. It's not there.
I mean, talking about Jamal Murray, man, is he talented. But he has had his difficulties staying on the floor.
And, Greg, that's been so unfortunate, and I feel for him. I mean, you can tell how frustrated he's been with the injuries that have saddled him. Because this is a guy you can tell who absolutely loves to play and wants to prove he can be counted on, and the injuries have just stonewalled him a bit the last couple of seasons.
The first free throw is good.
You know, this Denver team used to run a lot, but over the last few seasons, they've significantly slowed down their pace.
So Murray nails both of them. And the Nuggets, Clark, playing slower, more half-court basketball. Why?
Well, I think it suits the game of multi-time MVP Nikola Jokic. I mean, the Joker is a maestro in the post and on the perimeter as a passer and scorer. So he dissects opposing defenses from anywhere on the court. And the staff has adjusted how they play to fit Joker's skill set. That's a smart move.
That free throw, no good.
Wow, what, did he have something in his eye on that shot?
Maybe. Yeah, And the second free throw, good.
And we've seen it for years. Despite their regular season success, the Jazz just unable to make much noise in the playoffs. Credit the front office for coming to terms with it and pivoting to a rebuild while they could get top value for their stars. Well, they'll be happy with that look, even though it didn't fall.
You know what? That's a confidence shaker for him, though. I mean, that's a shot he expects to make every time.
Now, here's Sexton. He really played well in that last game against Golden State. And the dunk by Olynyk.
Sexton has to just keep developing his court awareness. You want to see more passing from him.
And it's the Nuggets with the ball. It's a three-point game. They come into this one following the loss to the Mavericks.
Yeah, they made some spectacular plays in it right to the very end. Just couldn't get over the hump.
Yeah, you know, they didn't have their best stuff, but they were still getting after it. So you got to really appreciate the effort and hustle.
Now, here's Clarkson after the miss from Kentavious Caldwell-Pope. And it's Kentavious Caldwell-Pope with the foul. That is his first foul of the game. First quarter of basketball, just over 2.5 minutes play. And stolen by Murray.
Clever, crafty defense. He saw that pass coming before it was even made.
And that's such good work to make this a one-possession game. Terrific steal to get it all started.
Here's Clarkson. He also stepped up against the Warriors in that win. Pass to Olynyk. Down low. And there's Sexton. That's good on the assist from Olynyk.
You know, you got to respect Sexton's scoring ability. The closer he gets inside, the more effective he is.
The Nuggets trail by three. Caldwell Pope outside. Outside, Porter. On the wing, Gordon. Back to Porter. Just five to shoot. Murray, no good. Jazz leading by three. Outside, Markkanen. Clarkson finds Sexton. Here's Markkanen. And the pass to Olynyk. And he gets the whistle. Two free throws coming up. There's a break in the action, so a rundown now. The most reliable power forwards and centers over the past month when it comes to shooting the basketball. Fifth, Aaron Gordon.
And it's one thing to be able to create high-quality shots for yourself, but you still have to finish. And there's no doubt all those guys can do both.
Yes, sir. I mean, these guys make the most of every one of their easy opportunities. Missing layups is simply not part of their routine.
Clark, how about the Nuggets? This core has really delivered.
Yeah, I like the young nucleus there, Kevin, led by the Joker, Nikola Jokic. I mean, one of the best in the West. I think they've built a perennial contender, definitely back on the map and in the thick of things. Got to get Porter Jr. and Murray healthy.
That's also good. So he hits both free throws. You know, G.A., something you notice about this Jazz team, they love to shoot the three. Statistics tell you that. And they tell you that.
And, Kevin, not only do they love it, they do it well. The two, sadly, don't always go hand in hand, but these guys can really hurt you from range when they get going.
Alexander Walker passes to Olynyk. Now here's Beasley, guarded closely. The Jazz need to get off a shot here, and the basket is good.
Yeah, they're going to have a nice little run here.
The Nuggets trail by seven.
They need a bucket in a big way here to regain some confidence.
Fires from deep. Hyland's shot is good.
Pick works well there. Not much resistance from the D.
Yeah, that's not the defense you need. You got to be tougher defensively.
1:15 left in the first quarter. Now the dish to Olynyk. Passes it to Alexander Walker. Over Smith. Jazz working now with the fresh shot clock. And that'll be Utah as it goes out of bounds. Jazz retain possession. And the Jazz making a change here. As Azubuike's checked in. There's 57 seconds left to play in the first quarter. Here's Alexander Walker. No good on that one. Now the Nuggets take it the other way. Smith outside. Gordon, the pass to Hyland. Back to Gordon. Here's Hyland. Covered by Beasley. Here's Gordon. And too long on the shot. Jazz leading by four. Beyond the arc. And that one is good by Beasley.
Oh, this is the kind of start they were hoping for.
Yeah, shots falling. Off to a very good start offensively as a result.
With the drive. And count it. The shot is good. He'll go to the free throw line.
Boy, that time saw daylight and took advantage.
For Denver, they have been perfect at the line so far, albeit just 2 for 2.
One shot.
There's 10 seconds left in the first quarter. Beasley for three. Two on the clock.
Yeah, how about the purpose with which he's crashing the backboards right now? Some hard-earned second-chance points.
And so the first quarter is in the books. Jazz out in front, up by six. And we'll get going after this from Ball Arena. For those of you just tuning in, the second quarter of action is where we're at right now. All right, we'll take a look now at how the points have been generated so far. A scoring breakdown for the Utah Jazz.
And they've set the tone from the jump. They're looking to pound it inside and score in the paint.
I would like to highlight, too, guys, the excellent passing they've done early on. I mean, they've done a really good job putting the ball into the hands of guys ready to shoot it.
Murray and Caldwell Pope, the guards. The post pair is Porter Jr. and Jokic in the middle. And it's Brown in at the small forward. That's the group on the floor for Denver. I've heard it said, Greg, a coach can't give you confidence, but they can take it away. What's the meaning behind that?
Well, players at this level are naturally confident, but when coaches are always critical, it can take you out of your game. Makes you just start to think a little too much on the floor.
And the shot is good. The Utah lead has been cut down now to just 5 on the basket from Jokic. Pass to Azubuike. Murray against Sexton. Deep 2 from Clarkson. Jokic grabs the miss.
Very surprising that he came away empty there, especially given room to operate.
Murray against Sexton. And Murray, here we go. Here's Caldwell Pope. It's good, he scores. That's his first basket after missing his first 2 attempts. Now 1 for 3.
A tough start scoring the basketball, but they're starting to turn it around now.
Yeah, it looks like they've gained a little bit of confidence as the lid has come off the hoop.
Now, here's Clarkson. Still looking for his first bucket in this one. Here's Caldwell Pope. And a lot of contact on that one, so he'll shoot 2 here.
Yeah, you got to be careful how you defend Caldwell Pope because he's got great speed and he knows how to use it to draw contact.
The Nuggets have yet to miss from the free throw line. They're 3 for 3.
Shooting 2.
And the first one drops.
A sharp shooter with a quick trigger release. Caldwell Pope is known for being an efficient scorer.
Kelly Olynyk checked in for the Jazz. And Caldwell Pope drops them both.
And you know there aren't many teams with a more dedicated fan base than Utah. The Jazz fans are behind their team no matter what.
Now, here's Sexton. He's certainly been a consistent piece of their offense, averaging about 14.5 points a game. Shoots from 12. Vanderbilt. And the dunk by Vanderbilt.
And getting better at distributing in the pick and roll. Sexton wants to evolve more as a passer.
The Nuggets trail by 3. It's always striking, Greg, to see the bond between the Jazz team and their followers.
Well, when you're the only game in town, people take the team to heart. And we see it in cities like Portland and San Antonio as well. The fans form that attachment to their team.
Now Clarkson following the three-point attempt by Jokic. Sexton kicks to Olynyk. The basket good off the assist from Sexton. Sexton's got his third assist on the night. Murray outside. And another miss by Denver.
The game has been very close in a lot of areas, but rebounding has been the one differentiator thus far.
We've seen it time and time again in games. Effort and determination on the glass can make up for a lot of other weaknesses.
Fans are really excited to see Michael Porter Jr. finally get back to his previous form, aren't they?
Yeah, Kevin, that 2021 season, he exploded, simply blew up. Averaged 19 points a game that season and made 44% of his threes. He's got the potential to be a real force going forward.
Shooting 2.
That free throw, no good.
And, you know, when Porter Jr. is healthy, I mean, he's got a lot of game. This guy is versatile. He's got good size. He's a multi-dimensional talent.
And he can't hit the second. And so Sexton will bring it up for the Jazz. Leading by 5. Last game against the Nuggets, they lost in the Mile High City.
Well, if they want to avoid the outcome of that first meeting, they'll need to be stronger on the glass. They were completely outmatched in the last one.
And sometimes that can be a motivating factor. May very well light a fire under them tonight. Nobody likes to be dominated on the glass like that.
And that's what you want to see. Good fundamental sound basketball with the bounce pass.
Parks and dishes to Markkanen. To the paint. Here's Olynyk. And he finishes nicely on the layup. Olynyk's got 4 points now in the quarter.
Yeah, that was the third straight high percentage look the defense has allowed. The defenders have got to start putting bodies on bodies.
Now here's Murray. He has 6. Pass to Jokic. Lets it go with a 3. A rebound by the Jazz. Clarkson looking for an opening. Draws contact on the shot, and now a 3-point play chance as he'll head to the line.
And really keeping the ball hopping around here offensively.
The last 5 trips they've had have ended with a great pass leading to a basket. They're really sharing the sugar.
And that one misses. And Markkanen can give you, Greg, a solid defensive effort at both the 3 and the 4.
And, Kevin, many thought Markkanen was a defensive liability. But give him credit. Worked hard to prove he wasn't. And while not a superb defender, he has become a plus defender for this team.
5 on the clock. Smith for 3. He can't get that one. And it's Utah the other way. And after this one, they're home against Minnesota. That game is the first and last of their homestand. Markkanen can't get it to go. The Nuggets trail by 7. Smith outside. The pass to Gordon. To the middle. Here's Highland. And the layup's good off the glass. Highland's got 8.
Boy, I like how Gordon dishes the ball. When his teammates are open, he finds them on time and on target.
For Utah, they've gotten exactly half their shots to go down here in the second, 5 of 10. Here's Alexander Walker, covered by Smith. Markkanen kicks to Beasley. This one for three. They get it back. Markkanen, good. Markkanen's got 4 points in the quarter.
And it's coming easy for them right now. 5 baskets in a row in the paint.
And I say, hey, if it keeps working, go to it. Stay with it. I mean, until the defense responds and provides more resistance, keep making them pay.
Oh, and just a soft touch on both ends of that pretty alley.
I got to say, when he threw the pass, I didn't know where it was going.
Neither did the defense.
Here's Alexander Walker. An 11-point game for him in the win against Golden State.
And his rebounding was solid in that effort as well. He did a lot of work on the glass. All around, just his effort level was off the charts.
So it's Denver now, following the three-pointer by Utah. There's 14 seconds left to play here in the half. Inside, stolen by Markkanen. Beasley outside. And so it's the Utah Jazz holding on to an 8-point lead heading into the break. They're pounding the ball inside, and that's where they've gotten their best production tonight. We've got more in store for you right after this.
Greetings, everybody. We love exciting, and this game is delivered as we've seen two top players battling mano a mano.
These guys are leading their way offensively. It's hard work doing all that scoring. Wouldn't you agree with that, Shaq?
Not for me, it wasn't. Piece of cake or barbecue chicken, whichever you prefer. Oh, both at the same time, because I'm hungry.
And now looking at where things stand at the half, there's some work to be done for the Denver Nuggets.
Well, it's never fun, Ernie. When you're playing against a team that's on fire. This team was on fire. They showed effort on defense, but it didn't matter. They couldn't get the stops. I don't think the opponent could sustain this kind of shooting.
Thanks for spending halftime with us. Time to get it back out to Kevin Harlan for the start of the third quarter.
We played through the first half. Plenty of basketball, though, left in this one. Without question, Kelly Olynyk displaying his skills today.
He's done a fantastic job of finding open space to operate within the first few quarters.
And you know what? It helped that they had a few guys with very hot hands on the perimeter, too.
And so in the game for the Jazz, Colin Sexton is out there with Clarkson. Then there's Jared Vanderbilt. Then it's Kelly Olynyk, and it's Markkanen in at the three slot. And here are the Nuggets now. After the basket by Utah, Jokic trying to free himself up. Murray, good.
That tenacity on the drive. Murray is at his absolute best when he's in attack mode.
Utah leading by 8. Sexton, the pass to Vanderbilt. Back to Sexton. Floats one, and he lays it up and in.
How about that wonderful floater he has, showing off an exquisite touch.
Here's Caldwell Pope. Right now he's averaging 11 points a game. Outside Porter from deep. That one, no good. And Utah the other way now.
Just a solid performance on the interior. The rebounding has been off the charts.
Yeah, you look across the board, it's actually sizing up, shaping up to be a great game. I mean, strong performances throughout, and they've really been strong on the glass.
Now, Jokic. After Jordan Clarkson missing on that last three-pointer.
Boy, one of the very best big men at handling the ball. Jokic's moves and creativity really set him apart as a big guy.
Oh, what an impressive dribble drive. That replay brought to you by Mobile One.
And putting that pressure on the rim. That's what it's all about, threatening with that attack.
Now, here's Clarkson. No points in the game yet for him.
the D just kind of stepping aside and letting him get to the rim.
There's a reason, GA, the lead is what it is right now.
You know, you look at it, the communication is lacking, as is the trust. They can ill afford those types of breakdowns. It won't work. You can't win with those kind of breakdowns.
And Denver decides to take their first time out here. And let's check out a breakdown looking at some of the stats for Lauri Markkanen. And it's the Nuggets with the ball, trailing by 10. Gordon with a screen on Sexton. Murray, no good.
It's a plus 5 advantage for them in rebounding after that one.
Oftentimes, Clark, with Jared Vanderbilt, his impact isn't reflected in the box score.
Yeah, you know, that's a good point, Kevin. He puts up solid rebounding numbers, but I think it's his defense, which is his greatest attribute. He's a lockdown defender, and he's a high-energy hustle guy who plays with a lot of edge and tenacity, and that has value on just about any team.
And he made the right read on that play, but just couldn't secure the steal.
You know, fellas, 1 second quicker, and that's going the other way.
Jazz on D. 10-point lead. This is their biggest.
And the passion Sexton plays with is so impressive. When he gets after it on defense, this kid is fun to watch.
And that one good from Clarkson.
Yeah, the chemistry has been terrific. Really impressed with their offensive execution.
You know, the defense has really been kept off balance because of the outstanding passes. 4 straight field goals have been made off an assist.
Gordon dishes to Porter. Outside for Murray. From deep. And another miss by Denver.
And that was a little bit of a range check for him.
You know, guys, I think he's got confidence to shoot it from anywhere, but he could have gotten a better one than that.
Now, here's Sexton. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line. It's going to be on Jamal Murray.
And how about the explosiveness of Sexton, a crafty floor general who is consistent in how hard he attacks the defense.
Shooting 2.
The first one falls. Greg, we're seeing more fines recently for the language that players use with the media. Is that a concern?
I don't think it should be a concern, and I'm not kidding. The league's going to have standards of decorum. You're on TV. You got to keep it together. However, I think that as a society, we're a little more tolerant of certain words that are used in public.
And he makes the first but misses the second. Hey, Clark, one stat where Jokic is consistently dominant, of course, is rebound.
Well, he does everything well, but you're right. Season after season, game after game, Kevin, he is eating that glass. He stays near the top of that particular statistic. And he knows games are won and lost on the boards, and he wants to be able to contribute in that way. But he is a brilliant, brilliant player, not just a rebound. Jokic doing a nice job there, boxing out the defense to earn a second chance shot.
And so, Sexton will bring it up for the Jams. Their defense has only allowed 6 points in the second half. Beasley with a clean look. The Jazz with another miss.
Total breakdown from the defense there. I mean, he'll usually take advantage when that's the case.
Passes it to Hyland. Caldwell Pope outside. And the lead is down inside single digits. Caldwell Pope's got 7 points.
Very effective at spacing the floor. Kentavious Caldwell Pope has gone from an average outside shooter to a dangerous one.
Sexton kicks to Beasley. Over Caldwell Pope. And it goes out of bounds. Last touch by Olynyk.
And a chance to check out some stats for Gordon. Unbelievable play for him over the last month. And also his field goal percentage is up in the top five. Tremendously efficient at finishing plays at the basket.
And back to your point, he's second in three-point accuracy. A lot of that has to do with mental toughness. It's just hard to force him out of his comfort zone. Smith kicks to Porter. Here's Hyland. 8 points for him. Astonaji down to five on the shot clock. Here's Hyland. Krills the three-pointer. He's got 11.
Yeah, there's 6 points on consecutive three balls. They're finding holes now in the D.
Beasley outside. Pass to Horton Tucker. Driving the lane. No good again that time.
Boy, that's a look. He has to finish, and he knows it. Blown opportunity.
And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here. With this break in the action, we can see the top passing teams in the league, courtesy of the 2K leaderboard. The Nuggets in second.
And contrary to what we see from other teams, this squad has no interest in playing strictly as individuals. Their assist numbers show what a cohesive bunch they are.
He's off on the first. Sexton, he's checked in for Nickeil Alexander-Walker. And he sinks the second. 56 seconds left in the third. Beasley finds Sexton. They set the screen. Down low. Shot clock at six. Here's Horton Tucker. And once again, off the mark by Utah. And it's the Nuggets ball. 9 points in a row. Good run for him right now. And it's denied. Smith against Sexton. Two free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul.
Such a menace close to the rim. You got to respect Sexton's fearlessness when he's amongst the bigs.
This is his second trip to the free throw line.
And this season, he's maintained very good form at the line, shooting at about an 83% clip.
Yeah, guys, I mean, he's been a very steady hand for them when it comes to his free throw shooting.
Free throw good, Sexton. That one goes in. Two from the line that time. 17 seconds left in the third. Outside, Porter. Out to Smith. From outside the arc. And the last second attempt doesn't fall. And so it's the Utah Jazz. With a 6-point lead at the end of the quarter, and it's been their rugged defense setting the tone. We'll take a quick break and then back to the action here. Moments ago from the huddle, let's listen in to Michael Malone.
Stops and run. Stops and run. Sense of urgency, man. Come on. We got to get this win.
Trying to stoke the fire under his team, Mike Malone asking his guys to seize the moment.
And this is the time when the leaders on the court need to step up, take control, and make things happen.
Well, what a terrific game it's been so far, with this fourth quarter sure to bring more pressure-packed basketball. Gordon steps in at the four with Jokic in at center. Ish Smith is out there with Murray, and it's Caldwell Pope in at the small forward position. That's the group in the game for the Nuggets. Now Smith. Gordon with a screen on Sexton. The pass to Jokic. And here's Sexton. From 12 feet out. And it's off the back rim. No good. The Nuggets trail by 9. Jokic high post. Markkanen on him. Jokic passes to Gordon. Good ball movement here by the Nuggets. To the inside, Caldwell Pope, good, and the assist goes to Murray. Murray's got 3 assists in the game.
With maturity comes greater patience, understanding how to play smarter. Murray keeps his options open and finds a teammate who's gotten free.
Now, here's Clarkson. He dishes it to Sexton. Down low. The 3. Rebound by the Nuggets.
And, you know, even though they're on top, they're winning. I mean, they could use more from him. Trying to shut the door on this one.
Caldwell Pope kicks to Gordon. Jokic against Vanderbilt. And Jokic slams it in.
At almost 7 feet tall now, Jokic can definitely throw it down. And he's happy to remind defenses that he can do so.
And we're about 2 minutes into the fourth quarter now. Clarkson against Murray. Back to Clarkson. Dishes to Markkanen. Crops in the layup for 2. And the Jazz lead by 7.
And I like that. Markkanen needs to play like a 7-footer because he's got the talent, but he also has a pretty strong frame when he wants to use it.
Here's Smith after the made shot from Lauri Markkanen. Passes to Jokic with the fadeaway. And there's another one for the Nuggets.
He's flipped the script here in this half, shooting a much higher percentage from the field.
Clarkson passes to Vanderbilt. Back to Clarkson, takes a 3, sinks the triple. Clarkson's got a couple of 3-pointers now in the fourth for the Jazz.
Improving shot mechanics, good height on that jumper, nice arc. I like what I see there from Clarkson.
Smith the pass to Jokic. Yes, and it's Smith with the assist that time. Jokic has got 10 points in just the second half.
Well, we've seen that movie a few times, haven't we? An easy bucket in the paint.
Well, listless and lifeless at the defensive end. I mean, especially inside. They've really got to pick up that interior defense.
Vanderbilt kicks to Clarkson. Just 5 to shoot over Murray. And that one goes long.
This shot's just, it's not there right now. With this team leading, perhaps, you know, let's focus on some other areas of the game.
Here's Smith, out of hand on it, and they'll get another chance. To the middle, here's Jokic, and Jokic slams it in.
Easy to understand why they turn to Jokic in these situations. He has a knack for cashing in on big possession.
And the Jazz call time here.
Adjustments are a part of the game, and the coach sees something he doesn't like here.
And you know what? We'll see what changes he makes coming out of this timeout.
Porter's checked in for Smith. Kelly Olynyk checked in for Utah. Horton Tucker comes in for Lauri Markkanen. Right now, let's send it over to the sidelines and get a report from David Aldridge.
Well, during that timeout, the coach of the Jazz talked to his team. He's encouraged where they are at this point in the game, but he told his guys, things can turn in a blink. What we need to do is execute the rest of the way. So we'll see if they can finish this one off, Kevin.
All right, thank you, David. Caldwell Pope against Clarkson. Outside for Sexton. Clarkson outside. Here's Horton Tucker. Another miss by Utah. And so it's Porter bringing it up now for the Nuggets. They've given up just 8 points in the fourth quarter. Pass to Jokic. Caldwell Pope outside. Jokic sets the screen for Caldwell Pope. And with that, the Jazz lead is cut down now to just two on the basket from Jokic.
Jokic calling his own number time and time again, taking over the scoring load tonight.
Jazz have gone 3 of 7 from the four in the fourth. That's a 42% mark in the quarter. Hudson against Caldwell Pope. Olynyk, a screen on Caldwell Pope. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot two at the free throw line. And some stats here, guys, the scoring breakdown for Utah.
And they're playing beautiful basketball right now, racking up the assists by playing so unselfishly, just finding the open man.
They brought the hard hats and the lunch pails with them, too. Done some great work down inside.
The first one, and that makes it a 3-point lead.
Absolutely the player they want on the line right now. Jordan Clarkson, a great free throw shooter.
Second free throw, no good that time. He really wanted that one.
Really a good free throw shooter. You'd like to see Clarkson get to the line even more because of that.
Pass to Jokic. Back to Murray to tie it up. Denver gets it back. It's in! And that shot brings them to within just one.
Oh, you just love seeing a player with absolutely no fear.
Cool, calm, collected, and confident in the biggest moment of the game. Yes.
Now, here's Clarkson. 41 seconds left in the game. And the call on the shot that sends him to the line. It's going to be on Jokic.
Nice, strong move there by Clarkson. He'll get free throws.
on the first, and that will put them up by two. On the second, that misses.
He missed the chance to put him up by three. You know he'd like to have that one back.
A shot by Caldwell Pope, no good. We've got a 9-second difference between the shot clock and the game clock, and now they decide to foul intentionally. Drops the first one, and that makes it a 3-point lead. Utah calls timeout. They're up by three. 27 seconds left in the fourth quarter. So both free throws are good, and it's a 4-point ball game.
And I don't need to tell you guys, those free throws are big. 2-possession game now.
Denver calls timeout. They trail by four. 27 seconds left in the fourth quarter. 3 seconds separate the shot clock and game clock. Caldwell Pope with a screen for Murray. Jokic draws the double. A three ball. Headshot off.
And there have been some terrible shot choices here, Kev. That's not a good look at all. Honestly, just doing what they have to in order to get the basketball back.
That's a good foul, though. I like that. I mean, clock management, crucial at this time of the game.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
First free throw is good, and that puts them up by five. So it gets them both, and it's a six-point ball game.
Sensing an opportunity here to increase the lead and capitalizing on it.
Denver calls timeout. They're trailing by six. 15 seconds left in the fourth. Guys, your thoughts?
There's still a sliver of hope.
Yeah, but they've got to score and then foul immediately.
Fifteen seconds left in the fourth quarter. Gordon for three. It counts. What a beautiful shot to bring him to within three.
Easy to see why Gordon has the ball in these moments. He's phenomenal at coming up big.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
The first one drops, and that gives them a four-point cushion.
And for a point guard like Sexton, a guy who handles the ball in big moments, you'll be at the line in this spot a ton.
He's off on the free throw, unable to get that second one to drop in. Caldwell Pope outside. Three-pointer. It's not going to go for him. And so it's Utah who scraped by with a win. They seem to relish their role as the bad guy here tonight.
You know, Kevin, I sense that as well. I mean, they really did feed off all of that negative energy this crowd was directing at them. I mean, they turned it around and used it as motivation to close out a significant win.
And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Thanks, Laurie. Strong start for the team. How did you keep that momentum going throughout the game?
Yeah, I mean, we've had leads before this season that we blew, so we had that mindset that even if we're up, we're still going to keep pushing, so that's what we did.
Kept the pedal to the metal, man. Congrats on the win. Back to you.
All right, David, great job. Thanks so much. And that's going to do it tonight, folks, for our broadcast. For Greg Anthony, Clark Kellogg, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. As we leave you with our New Balance Player of the Game, Jordan Clarkson.